baby. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
Take him to church.
Welcome to Sporting the Truth. My name's Garrett Turner, and Pat Welter, he's running the board.
I mean, it's not like I think Peyton Manning is going to be awful, but I think you're assuming that he makes this offense, you keep comparing to the Colts, I think you're assuming that he makes this offense click. But then that's not even talking about the receivers. They're two receivers, Demaryius Thomas and Eric Decker.
Star, Demaryius Thomas. A
potential star.
Oh,
he says 2-year experience has never broken 1,000 yards. So I mean,
what quarterback do you want him to break 1,000 yards with?
Sure. I mean, that's a totally reasonable point. But what I'm saying is that how is Peyton Manning going to be Peyton Manning? What made him so great was that everyone was in tune with his system, and these were veteran receivers, Reggie Wayne, Marvin Harrison, you know, smart guys in the slot like a crafty Austin Colley. And so all of a sudden, you know, Peyton Manning's going to come in this team, and everyone's going to be on tap with all the adjustments he was making, because I know damn well Tim Tebow wasn't making those kind of adjustments.
No,
he was just taking
all
the ball and running it.
People keep saying, oh my gosh, he's going to die if he takes a hit. Okay, I've seen Peyton Manning take one hit, and not know he was going to take a hit. And that was against the Steelers, James Harrison. I don't know when it was. But James Harrison cleaned his clock. Peyton Manning, when he's touched and he feels pressure, an ounce of pressure, just like he's always done, he goes down. Does he not?
No, you're 100% right. I mean, how
is he going to get hit? He's going to do exactly what he did his whole career, is go down when he feels the pressure. I don't know how he's going to get hit. Yes, people might blindside him, but I guarantee they take that, I guess it's the left guard, and they make that their best offensive line, offensive lineman. Always on Peyton Manning when you're dealing with protecting Peyton Manning, the left tackle is humongous because you don't want him to take a blindside hit like he did against James Harrison.
Well, I know. I totally agree with your point that Peyton Manning is, even though he's not the most mobile quarterback, is one of the best at not getting sacked. That's undeniable. But the fact is that now he's 36, had 3 neck surgeries, and if he does get that one blindside, that can knock him out week 1, week 4, right before the playoffs in that crucial game, whatever it is. And it only, I mean, the neck, I mean, geez, how fragile is that?
So that's my next thing is, I understand that the neck surgery, that could be the scariest term in football, right?
It's horrible, yeah. It's horrible. Nerve regeneration? Are you kidding me?
Right, but however, you know what also used to be really scary back before the day of modern medicine? Scurvy. It used to be a very scary disease and illness, okay? When people are on the boat traveling with goods, that used to be very scary. Well, guess what? If you eat oranges, limes, and things that produce vitamin C, then you fix it. We figured that out, just like we figured out Peyton Manning's neck.
Okay, all right. I see the logic, I appreciate the humor, but this isn't scurvy, this isn't polio.
Sometimes on Sporting the Truth,
I'm trying to ruffle your feathers.
Things can get a little bit...
I think he's a top 10 quarterback.
Heated.
Now you've ruffled my feathers.
And I think this is the year that he rises up to be a top 10 quarterback, because before Aaron Rodgers won a Super Bowl, he was only a top 10 fantasy quarterback. Come on and
turn me on. Jay Cutler has been partially the reason why his teams have been bad. Jay Cutler career is an average quarterback.
But ultimately, the truth is up to you.
Turn Sporting the Truth on every Sunday, 10 a.m. to noon, only on the Jock 98.7.